The European Association for the Study of Obesity, ESO, has unveiled a potentially groundbreaking framework that redefines obesity as an adiposity-based chronic disease, ABCD. Moving beyond traditional BMI measurements, this new approach integrates comprehensive health assessments to tailor personalized treatment plans. By emphasizing factors like body fat distribution, clinical staging, and holistic management strategies, the framework aims to revolutionize how obesity is diagnosed, managed, and treated, ensuring better health outcomes for individuals worldwide. Welcome to The Downsized. I'm Christopher Durham, and alongside my wife, Lorraine, we explore advancements in weight loss, particularly through GLP-1 therapies like Zepbound, Mounjaro, Wegovy, Ozempic, Semaglutide, and Tripeptide. And of course, we weave in a bit of opinion and insight as well. Today, we're delving into a shift in how we perceive and treat the disease of obesity. We're moving away from the simplistic body mass index, or as we know it, BMI, and toward a more nuanced framework thanks to the European Association for the Study of Obesity, ESO. My personal journey with weight loss has been shaped by GLP-1 medications, which have played a pivotal role in shedding over 70 pounds since September 2024. As we discuss these innovations, remember that our insights, my insights, Lorraine's insights, are based on our personal experiences and research. Always consult your healthcare provider before making any medical decisions. So let's begin and talk about the limitations of BMI. It's really a very narrow lens on defining obesity. For decades, BMI has been the go-to metric for assessing weight-related health risks. Yet its flaws are increasingly evident. BMI calculates weight in relation to height without considering body composition, muscle, fat, and bone mass. This oversight leads to misclassifications, often labeling individuals with higher muscle mass, such as athletes, as overweight or obese. Moreover, BMI fails to account for the distribution of body fat crucial in determining health risks. Visceral fat, which surrounds organs, poses more significant health threats than subcutaneous fat. The challenge here is many, many insurance companies, PBMs, doctors are using BMI as the be-all of defining whether people have the disease of obesity, and as we all know, it is much bigger than that. The ESO recognizes these limitations and has embarked on a path to redefine obesity diagnosis and management. Let's take a look at the framework. In an article in the journal Nature Medicine titled "A New Framework for the Diagnosis, Staging, and Management of Obesity in Adults," authors Luca Bassetto, Dror Dicker, Gemma Frubach, Jason C.G. Halford, Paolo Sprecia, Vulcan Umick, and Yis H. Usens presented the new framework. The ESO's framework represents a collective effort by these experts in obesity science and management to shift from a BMI-centric model to one that acknowledges obesity as chronic disease, or the fun acronym ABCD. In order to inspire change in the way obesity is diagnosed and managed among clinicians and understood by relevant stakeholders, ESO has developed this commentary proposing a new framework for the diagnosis, staging, and management of obesity in adults. We believe that this work in conjunction with similar initiatives can help to move obesity management in a direction more aligned with the concept of obesity as a chronic disease, said lead author Professor Luca Bassetto. The article begins, and I'm quoting, "Obesity is a multifactorial, chronic, relapsing, non-communicable disease marked by an abnormal and/or excessive accumulation of body fat that presents a risk to health. It is well established that obesity acts as a gateway to a range of other non-communicable and communicable diseases. Despite this wide recognition of obesity as a chronic disease, the clinical recommendations that guide the diagnosis of obesity and its management have not been aligned sufficiently with the clinical processes normally adopted for other chronic diseases. In many settings, the diagnosis of obesity is still based solely on body mass index, or BMI, cutoff values, and does not reflect the role of adipose tissue distribution and function in the severity of the disease." End quote. This team's new approach includes a few key things. Number one, a comprehensive diagnosis. So going beyond BMI, the framework incorporates assessments like waist-to-height ratio and clinical evaluations. This approach provides a more accurate depiction of obesity's impact on overall health, guiding tailored treatment plans. Number 2, staging obesity. Similar to staging other chronic diseases, obesity's severity is stratified based on clinical manifestations and associated complications. This stratification enables personalized interventions aimed at improving individual health outcomes. Number 3, a holistic management strategy. The framework advocates for multifaceted interventions encompassing behavioral modifications, nutritional counseling, physical activity, and when necessary, pharmacotherapy or bariatric procedures. This comprehensive strategy not only targets weight loss, but also enhances metabolic health and the quality of life. The approach shifts the focus from simplistic BMI measures to a more nuanced understanding of obesity. By integrating comprehensive health assessments and personalized treatment plans, the team aims to improve long-term health outcomes for individuals worldwide. According to Professor Tiusen, we anticipate that in conjunction with other ongoing initiatives, the recommendations outlined in this paper will contribute to improving obesity management and quality of life in individuals living with obesity. So then what are the role of GLP-1s in a personalized obesity management plan? And I think we can all see where this is going. As someone who has benefited firsthand from GLP-1s, I can attest to their transformative impact on weight loss and metabolic health. My blood pressure has gone down. My weight has gone down. My cholesterol has improved across the board. I'm feeling a lot better. GLP-1 receptor agonists like semaglutide and tirzepatide enhance insulin secretion, suppress glucagon release, and promote satiety, making them valuable tools in combating obesity and related metabolic disorders. Integrating GLP-1 drugs within the ESO framework have the potential to optimize treatment efficacy by aligning interventions with individual clinical profiles and health goals. So barring this one-size-fits-all number, ESO says let's build a strategy, a framework that can help each individual better manage their health. Just makes sense. This personalized approach not only fosters sustainable weight loss, but also enhances overall well-being and patient adherence to treatment plans. So what exactly are the implications of this for the future of obesity management? Well, ESO's paradigm shift from a BMI-centric approach to a comprehensive obesity management marks what could be a significant milestone in healthcare. Now, granted, this needs to be adopted by the industry, and there's a number of competing models out there right now. But there's got to be something more than BMI to help us better manage our disease. By prioritizing comprehensive health assessments and personalized treatment strategies, healthcare providers, your doctor, my doctor, can improve outcomes and elevate standards of care for obesity and its associated complications. For individuals exploring GLP-1s, if embraced, the ESO framework offers newfound hope and possibilities for achieving long-term health goals. If the PBMs, if the insurance companies embraced it, it may even offer opportunities for wider coverage. This represents what could be a pivotal advancement towards a future where obesity is managed effectively, emphasizing health improvement beyond mere weight reduction. That's our story for today. A little bit of a look at what ESO's doing. I think it's fascinating. I'll leave links in the description. So if you want to go read all the research that's out there, you can take a look at it. It's pretty interesting. I think there's still a lot of debate in the medical community and the scientific community about which framework needs to come out ahead, but this certainly looks interesting. If you'd like to explore our GLP-1 companion store, you can browse resources and join our community. Go to thedownsized.org. Please take a look at what we're doing there. Your support and engagement drive our mission to empower you in your journey towards a healthier life with GLP-1s and a lower weight. Thank you for joining me today on The Downsized. If you found this discussion informative, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comments below. Together, let's advocate for a future where obesity is understood, managed, and one day overcome. Until next time, I'm Christopher Durham for The Downsized.